This is John and Mary O'Leary.
Hello, Mary.
Ah, hello, Father.
They are reoccurring characters throughout the series, and they own the Craggy Island shop. They're portrayed as a traditional, unhappy Irish married couple who act nice to each other whenever the church is around.
We haven't seen you in a while. We were just going to have some tea. Will you have a drop?
Their first appearance is in the pilot episode, Good Luck, Father Ted.
Father.
Hello, John.
Will you have a pack of Toffos, Father?
No, thanks. I have to meet someone now. Actually, I'm going to be interviewed for a television program.
It's perfectly fine in front of Ted, but once he leaves, they're right back at each other's throats.
Good luck, Father Ted. Get them feckin' crunchies out of the can.
They also appear in the very next episode, Entertaining Father Stone, and they meet Ted and Dugo when they're at the hospital.
You've really done it this time.
You started it, you slag.
The next time I finish the job, Father.
Once again, they act like everything is completely fine, but they don't do a very good job at it. Luckily for them, Ted and Dougal are completely oblivious to it.
They're a lovely couple though, aren't they? John and Mary.
Ah, they are all right.
The first time we see them in their shop is when Dougal comes in to buy some handcuffs in the Passion of St. Tibulus episode.
No thanks, Mrs. O'Leary. No, I'm fine.
Well, what can we do you for, Father?
Well, I was looking for a pair of handcuffs, actually.
A pair of handcuffs?
Yeah.
What do you need them for?
Oh, nothing much. They're for me and Ted.
You and Father Ted?
Yeah. We're just trying something out.
Well, actually, funny enough, I think we do have a pair. Sergeant Thornton left them here when he retired.
Retired from what?
From the police.
The police? Was Sergeant Thornton a policeman?
He was, yes. Why do you think he wore the uniform?
Oh, I thought he was just having a laugh.
They appear in the shop again for the Old Grey Whistle Theft episode. They escalate the joke on how crazy everyone is being about the whistle being stolen.
Look.
Isn't it terrible, Father?
The whole island is talking about it. Who would have thought that law and order would break down here on Craggy Island?
God help us all, Father.
Yes, but I mean, if it's only a whistle, you know...
I had to buy myself a shotgun and everything. I wouldn't hesitate to use that now. If that man came in and tried to steal any of the whistles I have in here, I'd blow his feckin' head off his shoulders. Look, I have it cocked and all so I can get the jump on him.
Would that be dangerous to have it cocked like that, too?
Not at all, Father. So long as you don't suddenly drop it or something.
They stop by the parochial house in the Easter Lent episode to give some eggs to Ted and Dougal. John also inadvertently tempts Ted by smoking, which Ted decided to give up for Lent. Their final appearance is in Chirpy Burpy Cheep Sheep, where John locks Mary in a cupboard, but then Ted and Dougal walk in, and he has to try and find a way out of it.
And I've thrown away the key! How do you like that, huh?
Hello, John.
Hello, Father Crilly! Hello, Father Maguire!
Where's Mary?
Oh, she's away at her mother's.
Is there someone in the cupboard?
John says he locked Mary in the cupboard to protect her from the beast of Craggy Island, which escalates the joke even further from earlier in the episode.
I forgot you were there. I thought you were at your mother's.
No, I didn't go to me mother's after all. I'm in the cupboard.
Mary, what are you doing in there?
Oh, I know. It's because of this beast of Craggy Island thing. I thought that Mary would be safer in the cupboard.
That's right. I'm better off here. What can I do you for, Father?
Pack of 20 carols.
Certainly, Father.
I'll get them, love. You stay in the cupboard.
John, can I have a word?
Is Father Maguire there?
I am. Hello, Mary.
Lovely day, isn't it, Father?
Oh, yes.
You're looking great anyway.
I'm sorry, Father, a bet's a bet.
It's just that if the girl doesn't have the operation, she won't be able to fetch water for her village.
I am sorry, Father. It's a pity you didn't wait, though. The odds have lengthened to 20-1 on account of Chris's nervous troubles. Anyway, your cigarettes.
Thanks.
Ted, they don't have the sound effects album. We might as well just go.
Bye, Father.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, I hope you're satisfied.
Ah, shut up. Oh!